To actually be part of a project to try and improve the outcome of my residents had nothing but good music to my ears, if I'm perfectly frank with you. My job as the manager is to try and ensure that everybody has the best possible quality of life. You're a long time dead, so you've got to enjoy your life. And I think if that's how you look at how I wanted it for my parents, how I'd like it to be for me in the end, quantity doesn't matter. Quality does. So I'd rather have really happy residents that feel that they're supported in all of the aspects, not just the crucial ones like food and drink, but actually their personal well-being, what makes them feel good about themselves. So we've, as a result, we've changed a couple of things. I thought I did really well, and I do well in my home, and I've got a full-time activities coordinator and I have a part-time activities coordinator, and the roses smell great. But actually, there were things we weren't doing right, which is one of the reasons I wanted somebody to come in, because you think sometimes you're doing quite well, and reality is you can't see the woods through the trees, and you can always do things better. So I welcomed the researchers coming in with open arms. They were professional, polite. They were great with the residents, they were lovely to the staff. They were absolutely, completely inobtrusive, so they weren't in any way under our feet. They were really helpful. What I got from that was a real desire to make things better, to make people's well-being better. So we're still in this transition process of trying to convince people to give this bit up a little bit so that we can put a bit more in that pot. And we're getting there, and suddenly I turned around the other day and I had five carers that come down from different floors, and they were singing, if you're happy and you know it, to a group of residents in our coffee shop who were in absolute hysterics and trying to do the three motions with them. It was just, that's what it's about. Because actually, those residents are still talking about that now. They're not talking about the wash that they had yesterday. They are talking about what mattered to them and the fact that they laughed. And trying to get this ritualistic practice out of people that you have to wash people within an inch of their life has been a nightmare. Because do you know what? I might shower every day, but the vast majority of my residents never did. So I thought I can pinch a bit of that time. Let's keep their bath days, because they like that, they've chosen that. But let's take away that we need to do a bed bath in the mornings when the night staff are giving over, and at night when we're giving back over to them. Let's take some of that away. Let's do the old fashioned, have you heard, liquor and a promise. So we now liquor and a promise, and the residents are going, thank God for that. You know, and now we've got more time. So it's actually not just down to the activities coordinator. It's down to the people that have always been intimate and delivered that care. They're now giving it. And they're singing, and they're playing cards, and they're doing newspaper readings. So that's now cascading into the weekend. So I think we need to look, and you guys made me look, at what we actually have and how we can deploy that in a better way. So I'm very grateful. Thank you very much.
Hi everybody. I'm going to come from a slightly different angle. So I work for Bupa, and I've been privileged to work with a group of colleagues here. We got outstanding in one of our homes. When you get outstanding, you have to live and breathe being outstanding. And I think it's everything you do is outstanding. And that comes from research predominantly. So I was really interested to see the statistics on the board, because those statistics really show for me a picture. We know there's 196 nursing homes in the UK that are outstanding, out of about 20,000 nursing homes, rest homes and disability nursing homes. So it's absolutely tiny. When you look at those figures, you can see clearly why that is, because we are concentrating on personal hygiene, we're concentrating on safety, and a lot of those requirement, those homes that require improvement, get one thing wrong in their inspection, and it could be that the first aid box is not up to date. It's the smallest things that tip us over into requires improvements and gives us a really bad name. We're actually doing a really good job on a day-to-day basis. If you want outstanding, however, you need to be on the other side of that chart. So you need to be quality at everything you do. You need to be knowing what they want, when they want, and how they want it. And everything that you do has to be around their involvement And the other thing CQC are looking for under outstanding is the community involvement. So they're all areas that we're not really addressing, and whether that's because we haven't got the funds or the time or the right people in place, but nonetheless, it's not working in our nursing homes as it stands. And it's something that needs to be addressed. So one of the things we do in our nursing home is that everybody gets involved. It's not just the activities person's job. It's the carers, it's the kitchen staff. You know, you can dance around a hoover and make that an enjoyable thing. You know, you don't have to just sit there and do a bit of hoovering. Research for me, though, is a really fundamental part of outstanding. So not only does it instill best practice across every clinical area, but actually it makes us really question what we're doing, why we're doing it, on every fundamental level. I think fundamentally we're all human, we're all trying to do the best for our residents, and it is a 24 hour service. So I always give the example, when I do night visits, I'll go in, and one night I saw a carer with a resident in front of them, and she was giving her an Indian massage, and head massage. This was about 2 o'clock in the morning, and the woman said as I walked in, "If you stop, I'm actually going to beat you with my stick." She was enjoying it so much. And then I came in another time, it was 4 o'clock in the morning, there was a load of residents up, dementia at our unit, and they were all swinging, going, "Show me the way to go." Really inappropriate, but they were still up and they were still doing something. So it is a 24-hour process for us. It's a 7-day week, make sure everybody's involved. But for me, research is the way forward. Thank you very much.
Higher order domains are obviously a lot more important than what the other things are. Unfortunately, the way we're inspected, the higher order domains are seen as secondary, which is such a shame, because I would know that somebody would much prefer to have this lady sitting with them in their room, chatting about the polar vortex and how the snow affected us all, and what happened to a cat, how a cat was out, and then they were worried about the cat coming in. A good hour's conversation than that person having a wash. Now I know that. And this is what we're trying to push in our home. Now it's not easy to do, because what you've got to constantly do as the manager and your staff is you've constantly got to reinforce, why are we doing it and who are we doing this for? Are we doing it for the people who keep coming and inspecting us, the busybodies, the unfortunate KCC, the CQC? They're coming in. You've got a tile loose up there. I'm making a note of that. That's KCC. You've got a tile loose. I'm making a note. I want to know what you're going to do about that tile. CQC, similar, they've got a lot better, haven't they? They've tried to make themselves all friendly. They come in. We're very friendly, the CQC. We've ramped up, we're now, look, yeah, fine. But their sort of system of deciding whether you're outstanding, good, requires improvement, it's not ideal. The only way they're going to do that is if they stay with you for the week. They come in every day. Come in one day of the weekend, come in one evening, come in at midnight, stay till about four. That is the only way they're going to know whether your home is doing what it says on the tin.
Yeah.
That, not coming in for one day, and I'm on the best behaviour when they come in. Hello, Mrs. Jones, are you all right? Oh, no, knock on the door first. Hello, Mrs. Jones, are you all right today? Oh, so we see that woman made sure she'd knocked on the door first. That was good. She called her Mrs. Jones. That was good. No, not what really happens is I know Mrs. Jones quite well. I've got a very good relationship with her. I know her husband. I know her family. I know about the little Jack Russell called Binky that comes to visit her. I know all of those things. So normally when I go and see Mrs. Jones, I'll go in and go, "Hi, Dot, how are you today? You miserable? Are you all right?" Because I'm human and so is Mrs. Jones. And that's how we roll. So to have the research come in, and this was the second lot of university research we've done. A couple of years ago, we did one with Leicester University, and that was to do with Europe as a whole, and care homes in other, like in Italy and in Spain, compared to ones in Great Britain. this came to us to say, actually, we want to see what people feel like being in a care home. What impact does it have? So immediately I said, yeah, fine, come in, great. They weren't a problem, they were all very pleasant, they didn't get in the way. They affected the higher order domain themselves by being there. Because having a group of 35 over 80s, to have someone come in and you say to them, there's someone going to come in and ask you how you feel, they love it because they're going to talk about themselves. And they want to talk about themselves. Because when you become 85, you've normally got quite a lot to talk about. So to have some people come in who are going to sit there and listen to them, that's ticked one box already. Good, get them in. These want to talk, they want to listen. Fine, what could be better? So we would like to continually research with any university that contacts us. We do have our own research. We research quite frequently because we find that care at the moment is evolving continually. And soon we may get it to a way where us as the caregivers can be given enough sort of trust for someone to say, actually, you know what you're doing, look after those people. Now that would be the ideal way to go without someone coming and saying, but we need to know if you're doing it right. Not doing it right, we want to know if, are you doing things right or are you doing the right things? Because those two are different. So they want to come and look at that. However, they don't know what it's like because they don't do it. The KCC, with all due respect, they've got their own job, but they're not doing it. The CQC, all due respect, they've got their job, but they're not doing it. The amount of people that want to come and look at how we're doing something, but don't do it. So, you know, that's flawed. And so, finally, I think, and I've been a nurse since 1978, I've said for the past 2 years that one of the best decisions I've ever made, and it was based on research within our home, was say, and put it in writing so everyone knew, yes, you can have chips 3 times a week. Because following a big discussion with the residents and finding out what they thought about food, it came about that they said, actually, we prefer chips. But on one side, it's, are you making sure your residents are having 5 a day, fruit and veg and what have you? Well, that's all well and good. But a lot of people over the age of 80, they don't want that. Can we have chips? How often do you want them? Well, we'd want them 3 times a week. Fine, 3 times a week, chips it is. And that's one of my best decisions.